feasibility. Now, when you talk about the legal part of the business, most of the people ignore this. ये हमारे ये हमारा दोस्त है, इसको हम फ्रेंचाइजी देते हैं, कोई बात नहीं. ये हमारे पहचान वाले हैं, हम इसको फ्रेंचाइजी दे सकते हैं, कोई बात नहीं. मेक श्योर यू डोंट मेक सच मिस्टेक्स बिकॉज यू आर नॉट एन इंडिविजुअल, यू आर अ कंपनी एंड रन इट लाइक अ कंपनी. इंश्योर यू हैव ऑल दीज फोर स्टेप्स इन प्लेस बिफोर साइनिंग ऑफ अ फ्रेंचाइजी. मैक्सिमम प्रॉब्लम्स आर फेस्ड व्हेन यू डोंट हैव द राइट टर्म्स कंडीशंस मेंशन्ड इन द फ्रेंचाइजी अग्रीमेंट एंड देन यू हैव टू फाइट बैक विद द फ्रेंचाइजी फॉर सर्टन स्मॉल पेटी इश्यूज. Now, it starts with the application form. Now, what is an application form? It is basically a form that the franchisee fills up when they are interested to go ahead with your franchisee. So today, if example, I'm trying to set up a franchisee in Mumbai and I put an ad, say for example, I put an ad on Instagram and I get 15 inquiries for a particular location of, I would say, Bandra. So if I have 15 people who want to buy my franchisee in Bandra, do I have 15 vacancies? No, I probably just want two franchisees in Bandra, in probably one in East, one in West. Now what happens when you have 15 applications? So what you do is you make them fill up the application form, and the form should have those right questions which will help you filter down. The form should have the right questions which will help you filter down from these 15, which are the best 5, and I'm just going to meet those best 5 and finalize 2. Do you have the time to meet 15 people? No, you practically cannot do that because you might have a lot of people who are just putting in inquiries for the sake of it. So when it comes to the application form, it should have all those right questions related to the background of the franchisee. So it is their financial background, their family background, their social background. They should have the franchise, the questions of all of this, which should help you filter down the right franchisee. Somebody who is staying in Bandra for 5 years and somebody who has been there for 20 years, whom would you prefer? Definitely the one who's staying for 20 years because he'll have his own network. Somebody who is a part of, say, for probably 10 networking organizations, and somebody who is like an introvert who probably doesn't like to talk to people, whom would you prefer as a franchisee? Think of such questions, think and put these questions in the applications form. What happens here is when you put those right questions, you have the opportunity to select the right franchisee. Otherwise, you might just get engaged with the wrong guy or a girl, and you know then what happens. The LOI, that's the next step. LOI is a letter of intent. Letter of intent is generally signed before going ahead with the franchisee agreement. Now, what does letter of intent means? Like it clearly says intent, which means intention, that I mean I have an intention to buy a franchisee and you get a letter of intent signed from me. Now why not agreement directly? There are possibilities, there are chances that probably the franchisee has to arrange for funds, the franchisee has to search for a location, the franchisee has to probably they will need some time to streamline the things at his back end, though they are interested. But you know, all of this might take some time. It might take a month, it might take 2 months. Now, for all those 1 month, 2 month, are you going to just go ahead on their words? You will have to have some kind of documentation that you are sure of, that even after 1 month or 2 months, this person is actually going to buy my franchisee. Because if they have some commitment in terms of writing and in terms of the money, because at the LOI stage, we also suggest, we advise that you should take some amount, like a token amount from the franchisee to understand the seriousness of the franchisee. If he's just toiling around from here and there and trying to, also compare different franchisees with yours, it's just going to take away your time of 1 or 2 months and probably nothing would turn up. So LOI is extremely important when it comes to franchisees who are going to take some time to finalize. So LOI shows the real interest, the real intention, whether the franchisee wants to really go ahead with you or not. So here we also suggest that you should take some kind of token amount. Lastly, the franchisee agreement, which is the most important document in the complete franchisee process. This document should have each and everything that you think will can pose a problem with between you and the franchisee. It should have your branding terms, conditions. It should have your logo, usage terms and conditions. It should have your financial terms, conditions, marketing terms, conditions, operational terms, conditions. What if these people do not abide by this? What are the consequences? How are we going to deal with the franchisee who is not abiding by the laws? What are we going to do with the franchisee who is not able to clock the kind of sales that we expected? He's not able to take care of the franchisee. He wants to close a franchisee premature. So he wants to close even before the franchisee tenure is over, that is before 5 years. What happens in all these scenarios? The most important clause here is going to be the exit clause. What if the franchisee wants to exit way before 5 years? Is the company going to take over the store, or are they allowed to sublet? You will have to develop the terms and conditions in such a precise manner that you will, these things will definitely help you in defining, in ensuring that you build a successful franchisee network. And lastly, the sales pitch. So your initial sales pitch may not have the complete financial information. First, you need to gauge the interest of the franchisee and then open up your financial and the legal cards again in front of him. So these are the four important legal documentations which you must do with your franchisees when you're looking at giving away franchisee. I hope you guys, for all those people who think have already made the franchisee model, ensure you have all of this in place. Please make sure, if you don't have it, let's not hurry in just giving away franchisees, because that's the easier part. Managing and maintaining the franchisee is the most difficult part.